Holly Wilver and the fans here in Raleigh with both anthems. How many speeches would coaches have made to their teams this year? You take this back to rookie camp, and it's 270 or so days ago. Sixth-year man Craig McTavish running the bench tonight for Edmonton. First game seven for him as a coach.
As a coach, though, he used to be a player. They've won cups. The coaches have. Not one Stanley Cup championship has been won by one of his players. And all his players have said, we thank him, that man right there, for the way he's been able to keep us calm.
Second-year man with the Hurricanes, third game seven, coach Peter Laviolette, 1-1 in the prior ones. None of them were in the finals. Rod Brind'Amour will face off against Michael Pekka. Turned over now. Colin brings it in. Crosses. Shot off the Markkanen. Colin centering pass. And it went back off Andrew Ladd. Quick change for Carolina. Now it's Colin to the outside. Dropping it back over. Trying to get by now and holding and then feeding it past the Ladd. The great score! Aaron Ward!
As you see Cullen, who's playing his second game at center ice, a beautiful pass. Now you see the puck moved in front and it goes right to Ward. Look at the traffic. Markkanen did not see the shot. It was down low and on the ice. There's a beautiful pass back by Recchi. Look at the traffic down low underneath Markkanen. Before he could get down, it went underneath of him. Ladd was in front. Everybody was in front. And what a shift that was for Cullen.
Six attackers is heading to bench camp. Ward, a little feed in front of Backhander. Popped up in the air. And it went in, I believe, Cam. And it is Craig Adams who flipped it in the air. It bounced around the line, plopped down. The Hurricanes were celebrating. And what do we
penalty get? Penalty shot. Penalty shot if it's no goal, Mike. You can't, as a player, jump on the puck and cover it up in the goal crease. And Staios had it, not the goaltender. I thought the puck had gone in. Let's watch on the rush. Delayed penalty against Edmonton. Up in the air, back down. Is it in? Staios may have saved a goal. And if he saved the goal and it didn't go in, he's definitely on top of the puck. Look at the referee. Watson get right down on his knees to find the puck. So this will be a penalty shot if it's not a goal.
Okay, hey, look. John, I can tell you right now, I just heard Ryan Smith, the alternate captain for the Edmonton Oilers, say to Alyshemsky on the bench, no penalty shot, the puck was touched. And that's what I was trying to tell you, John. The delayed penalty tomorrow was the key.
And you're right, it's a faceoff on the near side to Markkanen. There'll be a penalty with 4.1 seconds to go in the period, but no penalty shot. And you try to follow the sequence of all the events. That's why the penalty shot was not allowed. They blew the whistle saying, penalty to Edmonton. On power play, Carolina, their third. They're yet to score, Pierre.
Well, you see the energy Cole's brought to the line, though. Recchi's got better jumps, and Staal's got better jump, and it's all because of the play of Eric Cole.
Here's a big score!
Jason Smith's on the puck, but Brind'Amour got in there and knocked the puck down. It stays alive. And Cabrelet through the screen, a big time shot that finds the net. What a play by Rod Brind'Amour. Oh, the puck went off the hip of Jason Smith. And it changed speed and direction past Markkanen. What a play by Brind'Amour.
Back up with it now, Rafi Torres with a man breaking save. More rebound, another save. Rebound, score! The third man coming in was able to lift it up.
Mike, it was amazing. Y'all, we were looking at Pekka getting helped over the bench. He's still hurt. You see him there with a trainer. As that's happening, one shot rebound. Second shot save. Third shot. It's not him again. Yes, it is Pisani. Unbelievable. 14th goal of the playoffs for Fernando Pisani. He gets to the net. Recchi doesn't hold his stick and check. And it's in past the goaltender. A big collision once the puck is over the line. Puck is over the line, then the collision, then the net off to Mooring. Edmonton's back in the game, 1:03 into the third period.
23 shots for Carolina, 18 for Edmonton. A nice pass ahead now for Ray Whitney. Whitney crosses, pursued by a couple. One falls. It's the Cullen, and it's shot and blocked by Smith. Drive, and that went in past the glove of Markkanen. Right back ahead is Morrow getting by. Save made by Morris. Rebound, and Morrow sent to the corner by Moline, moving in as Pronger with it. Sent it around behind, and it was away from Morrow. Good hit at the half boards. Drive by Smith, and it got the high glass behind. Both teams in the midst of a change. Hemsky on a cross. Got it on to Torres. Stuck by! Torres a shot, and he got the glass! Oilers have to outlet. Long toss from Pronger. Swept across, and Horkoff ahead. Drops it back off. Ryan Smith a shot. Knocked down in front by Hennigan. Rebound is grabbed by Ward.
Edmonton giving it everything they have. And we may have a penalty. Bill McCreary, yes, his arm is up. It's in the air. We have a penalty. It's a roughing call. It's Brett Hennigan, who's now appealing, but he put a fist right into somebody's face.
They jam along at the half boards, and it came loose. Hennigan knifed it on. Brought back up by Stahl. Given back across to Williams. Score! The first two games they played in the playoffs back in mid-April, they lost. Then they won the next four and the two rounds after. They have been absolutely relentless. Brindamore with the net empty. Pronger shrugs it away. The Carolina Hurricanes have won the Stanley Cup.
Congratulations to Jimmy Rutherford, Peter Laviolette, all the players on the Hurricanes. Rob Brindamore, I'm proud to present this to you.